Praise the Lord, my friends. It's so good to connect with you once again. I want to welcome you to Praise. And today, I want to believe God with you that the Lord will bless you with the ability to have a clear purpose for what you do, a clear purpose for what you intend to do. It could be the fact that you want to get into a particular business, a particular job, a particular assignment on earth, or you want to even get into marriage or a relationship. Why do you want to get involved with what you want to do? Because purpose will always answer the question, why? Why do I want to do what I want to do? Having a clear purpose also means that your motive is correct for what you want to do. You have a good motive. Your conscience is right for what you want to get involved with, because you do things for a reason, and it's important to understand that reason and be able to do it so that in the end there will be profit. In the end, you can succeed. In the end, you can yield a good harvest when you have a clear purpose for what you do, in Jesus' name. You know, one great writer, Dr. Miles Monroe, he said this, that when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. When purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. So it's important to understand the purpose for everything so that you can use it properly or rightly, in Jesus' name. And so I want to bring to you a verse in the scriptures, 2 Samuel chapter 18, verse 22. And Ahimaaz, the son of Zadok, said again to Joab, "But whatever happens, please let me also run after the Cushite." So Joab said, "Why will you run, my son, since you have no news ready?" So in those days, there were runners. Runners were like postmen who were responsible for carrying carrying information from one end to the other. And so on this particular occasion, Joab, the one responsible to send somebody, said to a Cushite, a man, and said, "Can you take this message and run and give to King David?" But this other man, who is called Ahimaaz was the most popular runner at the time. He was supposed to be selected for this particular job, and he felt that he had been, you know, sidelined. So he went to Joab and said, "No, whatever happens, you must also let me run." And Joab said, "But you don't have the news. I've already given the job to somebody else. Why do you want to run?" Ahimaaz said, "No, I still want to run, even though I don't have a purpose. I don't have the assignment. I don't have the news to take. I still want to run." And in fact, he asked him to run. So he ran, and he got to where he needed to get to before the Cushite, who had the news, was able to get there. But when he got there, David said, "What do you have to tell me?" He said, "I have nothing to tell you." And David said, "Stand aside," until the Cushite, who had the message, came and delivered the right message. And so when you run without a purpose, you can get to your destination, but then you will lose the essence, the reward, the reason why you got there will not be in your hands, and that will not be a very successful run or assignment. And so I want to pray with you today that you will run with purpose, a clear understanding for what you do, in Jesus' mighty name. Let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for somebody today that their purpose will be clear, that the motive, the understanding for what they do will be made very clear to them, in the name of Jesus. I pray that it will not be said of anybody under the sound of my voice that they got involved with something for nothing. I trust, my God, that everyone that has a purpose, everyone that has an assignment, it will be an assignment with a clear purpose, so that in the end, a good testimony will come unto your people and unto everyone that is running and doing what they got to do. In Jesus' mighty name today, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen and amen. God bless you, my friends, and thank you so much for connecting with me today. My name is Simeon, and I look forward to connect with you once again. Stay blessed.